إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونتوب إليه من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا وقائدنا محمد ابن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه، أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين فجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة فمحى الله به الغمة، فاللهم اجزه عنا خير الجزاء. سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، فيا أحباب رسول الله ويا أتباع رسول الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله، فمن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. إن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أحبائي في الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I bear witness there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his final messenger. Oh, you believe, fear Allah. Fear Allah and don't die except in the face of Iman. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us from every newly invented matter in the religion of Islam can take you in the wrong path, can end you in hellfire, wal'ayazu billah. Indeed, the best word is the word of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillahi ala ni'mat al-iman. Allahumma laka alhamdu hamdan da'iman mubarakan yaliqu bi galali wajhika wa azim sultanik. أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك حرم وجوهنا ووجوه والدينا ووالدي والدينا عن النار. الذنب كبير والعمل قليل ولا نسق إلا في رحمتك وأنت أرحم الراحمين. Today our topic is our family and how they are facing the coronavirus and the pandemic. And are we addressing this topic according to the Islam, and how our teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam reflect in this time. And we need to remind ourselves and our beloved children that by the taqwa, this is the way we can survive from this calamity. Then a taqwa, as Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, explain it and say, a taqwa hiya al-khawfu min al-jaleel wal-amalu bil-tanzeel والرضا بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. التقوى, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fear him and to don't commit sins and to try to live according to the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah. والرضا بالقليل, to accept what Allah give you. And we indeed right now we recognize the ni'mah that we were living, and right now a lot of things have been taken away from us, and the luxury that we've been living is now for us that we cannot imagine that we are not living the way we used to live. Then وَالْإِسْتَعْدَادُ لِيَوْمُ الرَّحِيلِ, and to be prepared for any moment that Allah can take your soul. And also Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said a beautiful words, and he said مَنَ اتَّقَ اللَّهُ وَقَاهُ, and whoever fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and work in his teaching of the Quran and Sunnah, Allah waqa, Allah protect him, subhanallah. Al-mu'min and the believer in this dunya is between two things, between a sin that he commit and between the ni'mah that Allah bestow upon him. Then the believers, he's living between shukr for the ni'mah and istighfar for he's committing a sin. Then is if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow mercy upon us and give us the ni'mah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shukr. And if we commit a sin that we make an istighfar, we ask him Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Then we need to understand the taqwa and teach our kids and say, taqullah, اتق الله في وقتك. To fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your time. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the food that you're throwing away. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're complaining that you don't have what others have. And التقوى أن يطاع الله فلا يعصى. Then you التقوى, if we complete the taqwa, حق التقوى, how can we do the taqwa? Then we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we don't commit a sin. And يذكر الله فلا تنساه. And you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you don't forgive him, you forget him. And شكر ولا تكفر. And then you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then don't say, why me, why me? Then we have to also teach ourselves and beloved kids also that supplication, the dua, is the only thing can switch and turn the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what Allah wrote can be switched by your dua and supplication. Then if you are, you know, and beloved one, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you this or to protect you from this or protect you from this calamity, then subhanallah, Allah can change the qadr, the, what he wrote for you. And also we have to understand that this waba, this calamity, this disease, a virus, is jundun min junudillah. It's a soldier, it's Allah created. And yusabbih, and also he making tasbih, but we don't understand it. And we have to understand, لِكُلِّ دَاءٍ دَوَاءٍ. Every disease that Allah created have a cure except the death. Then inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will discover the cure for this virus. But we have to understand that by the taqwa, we can get out of that. And by teaching our beloved kids, which is they are amanah. You know, our kids is amana. وَإِذَا ضُيَعَتِ الْأَمَانَةِ فَانْتَظْرُ السَّعَةِ. If we lost this amana that Allah gave it and bestowed it in our neck, that we have to remind them and remind our family that we cannot get out of this without the taqwa of Allah, and explain to them what's mean taqwa, that as I told you and as Ali radiallahu anhu said and as Umar radiallahu anhu said and as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches all of us, then we have to supplicate. And we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have to give charity. And we have to appreciate what we have from ni'am. And we have to understand that we will be asking about the time that we spent. What did you do with this time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you? Are you spending this time right now watching TV and playing games, and you think that you are isolated and you are protected? Then you didn't learn the lesson from all the whole pandemic thing. As I was speaking to my family members and we were talking about this kind of virus right now, and we translated to a simple topic to be understood to our beloved kids, as you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, as this computer was created by a human being, put it together and give it to, you know, the capacity for memory and this and this. And subhanallah, we are better than any computer that Allah, you know, that any human being created. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us better than anything. We have better memories than any computer have. And we have the better eyes than any cameras that being bestowed by iPhone or anything like that. And we have memory and capacity, and we can carry files more than any computer on earth. But subhanallah, when we are loading this and we are getting all this garbage in our brain that is no use for our brain and our life and our soul, that our system as the computer, I asked my beloved kids, the young kids, I said, when your computer, your laptop is like overdue, you know, like old version, what will happen? He said, like, it's getting slow. We upgrade it, or we change, we buy a new version or something like that. Or, you know, you have a virus running in your, you know, running in the background, and then you have a problem. Exactly our system right now, we have a virus, and we have to run an antivirus. And the antivirus for our soul, our computer here in our body, is to cleanse this memory, the garbage that we have, by zikr and ibadah and istighfar and salah and taqwa. To, you know, we have to understand the taqwa. Man attaqa Allah waqah. Whoever fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah protect him, inshallah. Then how can we fear him? That we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do and live according to the Quran and Sunnah, and also to be prepared for the Yawm al-Rahil, to have our luggage ready beside our bed in any time we are travelers. You know, we are traveler anytime. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed mercy upon us and we were saved from this calamity, but I know that one day I will face my destiny and I will die, then I am ready to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you ready? I am ready. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, we're not ready yet. We have committing a lot of sins and we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And Allah is tawwab. Allah is ghafoor, raheem. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we get the message clearly and our beloved kids get the message clearly and we understand that everything in our life will be asked. We will be asked about our time. We'll be asked about the ni'mah that He bestowed upon us. He will be asking us, did I send you the message? Did I send you this virus? And you still insist that you continue the path that you were going through. Then indeed our kids are very smart and they need some guidance and they need some clarity in the mind. And we sit down with them and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us all and our beloved kids, inshallah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide our family and to protect them all, inshallah. Inni da'an fa'aminu. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa barikallahu lana fi ma a'tayt. Allahumma asrif anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-firdaus al-a'la, wa kulla ma yuqarribu ilayha min qawlin aw amal, wa na'udhu bika min an-nar, wa na'udhu bika min an-nar, wa kulla ma yuqarribu ilayha min qawlin aw عمل. اللهم أحينا على الإسلام وأمتنا على الإسلام وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على أشرف المرسلين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.